Welcome back, Dark Souls fans. Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls 3. I remain your host, ChadisFury333, and yes, we are back here because I realized I forgot this ladder. There's a ladder here. If you want to hide anything from me, put it at the top of a ladder or in a sewer. Either way, I'm going to miss it. I don't know what it is. It's just ladders. This is not the first ladder I missed either. I think near the beginning of the entire series, I missed a pretty important ladder. Oh, hey, it's Havel. With a dead dragon. And they're apparently none too friendly. Actually, one thing I want to do... It occurred to me that I made some assumptions in a previous episode. But I'm not going to act on those assumptions quite yet, because I actually kind of think my current setup is pretty good. I mean, my ring setup... Alright, you are definitely as hostile as you've always been. Oh, wow. Okay, don't get hit. Got it. Ah! Hey. Oh, yes! Got the backstab. All right. Wow, that takes forever to recover. It's so useless as shield breaker. What the? Okay, apparently Havel's a pyromancer now and has stone skin. Or is that a pyromancy? Can't remember. Ow! That actually hit me. Okay, good. That's over. There we go, and a front stab! And let's get the deep protection going again. Nope. That's not what I wanted! Thought you were down for longer. Try that again. And another backstab. I think I've got Havel dead to rights. I'm not sure. Nope, I don't. I'm not dead, but I don't have him dead either. And let's end it the way I always love to end it, with a crossbow bolt. Late game Havel fight. That's a new one. I mean, granted, Havel was supposed to have been to- Hey, Titanite's lab! This was totally worth it! Now I gotta figure out what upgrade. Probably the Wolf Knight Greatsword. I almost want to wait until I see every single weapon I could possibly get through a run, like all the boss weapons from the remaining bosses before using it. But I'm not going to- I got armor, I think, or was it just the... It was the Dragon Tooth, wasn't it? Okay, so Havel's Great Shield, first off. A tremendously solid and heavy Great Shield, cut straight from Great Slab of Stone. Said to be a relic of the legendary... Havel the Rock, along with the Dragon Tooth. The shield is imbued with a special power reminiscent of Havel himself. The skill is Stone Flesh, which we saw, which was... that you become stone. Then Dragon Tooth. It was created from an everlasting Dragon Tooth that will never break. Left by Havel himself, along with its boulder-like great shield, grants his will the resistance to magic and fire. And it boosts poise when you skill with it. Wow, I've got to store out a lot of these weapons. Time for give it up. Oh, the grammar. Anyhow. So that's cool. Anyway, the thing I was talking about is I realize that... Like, that Ring of Favor I was talking... Oh, I can't talk about it. I'll talk about the Ring of Favor later, because I thought... I realized I may have made an assumption about whether or not it could break, and I should actually test. Like, I should really be testing things, because this is not Dark Souls 1. And although there are a lot of references, this is not Dark Souls 1. So, I can't assume. But, eh, might be right. Titanite's lab for weapon reinforcement, said to once belong to the gods. Reinforces weapons at their highest level. Titanite's labs are smithing materials of the gods, and weapons reinforced with slabs will be admired no less than their precious legendary weapons. So, my thinking is that I want to upgrade the Wolf Knight Greatsword. Like, it's kind of, there's kind of two ways of looking at it. One is the Wolf Knight Greatsword is basically only upgradable with the Titanite's lab at this point. That's the last thing left, and it's going to be a pretty huge jump in power because boss weapons, they have huge jumps in power. Whereas with the longsword, that's a smaller jump in power, but much more comparatively useful. Like, compared to the rather slow Wolf Knight Greatsword, the longsword is really useful. It comes up all the time, and why wouldn't I want to use it? Whereas the Wolf Knight Greatsword, if I upgrade it, it's now worth having as a differentiator from the longsword, because the longsword would be less powerful. I have to think about it, actually. So, yeah, also, do you have any you have more green blossoms, yay. And one, what the heck, cheap green blossom? Oh, interesting. Well, budding green blossom, large temporary boost to stamina recovery speed, and the brief attached message suggests that it was a gift. Goodbye, dear grandmother. I will visit grandfather in the Pit of Hollows. Okay, that's curious. I don't really care for it. I know I was complaining about stamina recovery, so I probably should get some green blossoms, but eh, it's Chloranthi Ring. But yeah, so I will, I guess, head over to the Pit of Hollows after doing some thinking on weapon upgrades.
Oh, great. Well, now that that task is concluded, what would you have me smith today?
Wow, I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to miss all that. I didn't realize that'd be new dialogue.
I don't want... Ah, tis good one.
Crap. Okay. See you in the Pit of Hollows. Oh, hang on, one sec. Let's just double check this thing I got off of Andre. Hawkwood Swordgrass, Bloodstained Swordgrass of Hawkwood, Deserter of the Undead Legion. Traditionally, the Undead Legion of Farron sends the gravest of messages using Swordgrass. Come to the mausoleum in Farron. Only one can take the path of ancient dragons. There was a mausoleum in Farron? Well, whatever. Pit of Hollows is the first thing on the checklist. Sorry, we'll get to the Grand Archives eventually, but this happens. Also, I upgraded the Wolf Knight Greatsword. I figure... What the... Okay, something went weird. Sorry about that. If the video went all wonky, I'll just restate what I was saying. So, first off, we have the Hawkwood Swordgrass, which I'll get to after we deal with the... Well, basically, there's a message that says, come to the mausoleum in Farron, and only one can take the path of ancient dragons from there. So I don't know if there's a mausoleum in Farron Keep, I guess, or what, but yeah, something. It's weird. Also, all right. Anyway, I don't see anything down here. Right. To the upper section. All right, first, before I start doing stuff, let's just point out what the Ring of Favor, okay, experiment the Ring of Favor. I put it on, it's there. I take it off, it's still there. I can put it on, okay, so it does not break. The Ring of Favor does not break in the way it used to. That's really good to know. Doesn't seem to boost my health all that much though. Yeah, life would actually be more efficient. Stamina wouldn't be boosted, mind you. And equip load wouldn't be boosted. But I already have Havel's Ring, and this is on top of Havel's and the Prisoner's Chain, so I'm not going to worry about it. Like, maybe, but the thing is, right now, what the Prisoner's Chain's doing to me is I have Endurance and Vigor well above my level. And, yeah, my Absorption's low, but I think I might actually be able to just have like 35 endurance and maybe even pull up attunement to 20 whatever that I need for the next attunement slot. But yeah, so stuff. Hey, another sound requesting cooperation. Hey, it's Cirrus again. Okay. Is she okay? I'm guessing no, because otherwise why would she summon me?
I finally found you. Just as I promised, Granddad. Remember?
Get that sword buffed up, why not? Oh, right. Estusing up all the time, aren't you gonna be? Well, we'll deal with that eventually. What? I died? Shoot, why don't I have my Estus on command? Wow, hopefully this doesn't fail the quest entirely. Oh, good. I don't have to jump. I don't have to run back. And apparently I didn't fail. My guess is if Cirrus dies, then I do fail.
I finally found you. Just as I promised, Granddad. Remember?
Oh, right. That is poise. Oops. Yeah, backstabs. Am I gonna chain? I think I am. Yeah, that's what's happening. Oh, what? How did I miss that last one? Why did they code the AI to Estus in this situation? It just makes everything take longer. Oh good, finally, they're out of Estus. Nice try! Alright, well, took me 2 tries because forgot to load up Estus, but okay, whatever. We got it.
Good night, Granddad.
I feel like I was supposed to have done that a long time ago, but whatever. I figured it out already. Finally. Now. Eventually. That felt easier than the last one. Oh! I got into the mount. I got the Mountain Maker's Covenant signed for that, apparently. Yes, I did! Mountain Makers, a malformed vertebrae found by the Mad with a queer symbol on its inside. Proof of the shackles of the gods. Equipped to pledge oneself to the Mountain Maker's Covenant. The Mound Makers wish only to add to their mounds, becoming mad spirits whether summoned as cooperators or invaders. They are blithe to those around them, for in their minds any kill might lead to another shackle. Huh. Interesting. That actually explains a lot. There's a setting that I was curious about for a while, which is summon sign visibility, whether it's restricted or unrestricted, and I'm guessing that means that if Mad Phantom summon me, then I'm in for a fight. I don't know, though. Sounds like it's not that. It sounds like it's just... Yeah, when you're a Mound Maker, you can just... a white soapstone sign as a Mound Maker, you get summoned as a Mound Maker, I guess, to fight. Alright. Well, that is curious, but I guess we're done here. Hey, Cirrus. You're here again.
Oh, I'm afraid I've involved you in my affairs over a little promise at that. My sincerest thanks for your assistance. At last, my grandfather will rest in peace, and I can die. But there is one last, may I take a vow, to serve you as a knight.
Sure.
Oh, I am most grateful. I, Cirrus, do hereby serve as your faithful knight, wherever, whenever I am needed. My loyalty shall never waver.
Forgot to record that line, huh, game?
Blessing of the moon upon your journey. If I may ever, I am your blessing of the moon.
All right. I guess so. That's kind of cool. All right. So now we have something else. Something about a mausoleum in Farron. I don't know. I honestly don't know. Like, what? Are they talking about the catacombs? Honestly, I don't care enough. Let's go check out the Grand Archives. Like, I'll check that out. If I can find anything off camera, then I'll start recording and just put that into probably the next episode. But I'm not gonna worry about that right now. We have Grand Archives to explore and game worlds to become sluggish totally. That was really odd. No clue why that happened. I English. Well, that's a crystal sage. That's one crystal sage. And of course, this is crystal sage. So it's gonna be a right pain in the behind for a while. Whoa, what the? All right, well, if we're dealing with this. Shoot. I'm going to assume this is non-responding crystal sage. And in case you're wondering, I have lost deep protection. That's the miracle. I just gave up for doing that. Oh, and Estus on. Do not have Estus off. I've learned already that's a great way to die. Hey, crystal gem. Huh. Does this place have mechanisms that create bridges or what? I guess that might just be a way around. All right. Where am I being attacked from? Crystal Sage went off into a random direction. I don't know where they went. All I know is they're above me and a threat. Well, you're not above me, but you're a threat too. And a coward. Ow. Shoot. I didn't roll the right timing. Didn't realize thralls could be so strong. Well, that's annoying. Alright, well. The sign did say, be wary of tough enemies, so that's what they were talking about. Old deer, okay, it's not quite what I thought, but. No, there's the. Well, that's half his health gone. Oh, that's where the other one is. And yeah, I realize the irony of calling one of them a coward while attacking from range myself. But I think we've all seen how these things fight. And really, my style of shoot an arrow as you're trying to get away, or shoot a bolt rather as you're trying to get away, pretty much counters that. What the heck are those things? There's something up there. Did not look friendly. Hey, Titanite Chunks. Yay. Wait a sec. Oh, I made a mild, probably not particularly terrible, but still somewhat annoying mistake. I probably wouldn't have been remiss to upgrade the light crossbow, but I'm not going to regret it too much. Like, I don't think it wouldn't necessarily be a great idea to Titanite's Lab the light crossbow, yet it'll probably be third or fourth, assuming I get enough Titanite's Labs to upgrade my entire set of equipment, which I honestly don't think I'm going to get. I'm pretty sure I'm only going to get enough Titanite's Labs to upgrade maybe one more piece of equipment. Like, in one, I think you got, if you really explore the whole place, three Titanite's Labs maximum in a single run. So I'm not expecting any more than one or two. Gotta say, the design of this area is already pretty intriguing. I mean, basically, at this point... Okay, there's a trick here somewhere. Basically, at this point, I'm trying to find... Like, there's an enemy that's firing down at me at all times that I'm trying to find, and that is my goal. So I have this big overarching goal in the area that I've immediately got because there's this enemy that I encountered that teleported away. And I mean, it's an old boss enemy that they stuck in here. Not really unique to this area, but still, it's motivating me to be terrified. That dealt nowhere near as much damage as I had feared it would. Alright. Ah, and your crystal charm or whatever is off. Why can't I react to that? Like, what is with my reaction time? Come on, me. You can do this. I know you can do this. Why are you not doing this? Do the thing. Well, that went much better than the last time. Also, I got a new another weapon! Scholar's Candlestick. What does it do? Wherever it is. There it is. Scholar's Candlestick. A candlestick covered in ivory scales once used by the Scholars of the Great Archives. This served as their guiding light, as well as a tool of self-restraint. Even today, the wielders of this weapon benefit from the resulting sorcery-strengthening properties. Skill is guiding light, and it creates light. Well, that seems relatively useful if you have the intelligence for it, which my character does not... Because my character does not have intelligence. Crystal Chime. And a big... Is this supposed to be a reference to Big Hat Logan? Like, this... The corpse here with all the stuff set up inside an area that's clearly reminiscent of the Duke's Archives from Dark Souls 1. Anyway. Crystal Chime is probably... Yeah, that's what I thought. For sorceries and miracles. A sacred chime, once the possession of Gertrude, the Heavenly Daughter, and defiled by the scholars of the Grand Archives. The power of crystals granted the scholars a degree of success. In this case, their work enabled this chime to be suitable for casting both miracles and sorceries. Assuming you have enough intelligence and faith, though I suppose if you're a hexer, this is perfect. Or, well, int faith build for dark magic. I guess hexing isn't really a thing anymore. Hexes aren't really a thing anymore. So that's apparently Gertrude's, I'm guessing. But the way this room is laid out, the way it's kind of, it's not as much of a mess as Big Hat Logan's room was, but still, the way it's laid out, the entrance to it and everything, it just reminds me of the room Big Hat Logan was in when he went mad. Well, before he went mad, actually. He was perfectly sane in that room. It was after that room was all over and done with that he went mad. Anyway. Well, once you got out of there, it's a long story. Actually, it's not a very long story at all. I just don't really remember it very well. It's a short story poorly remembered. And there is a Titanet lizard here, and that's bugging me. Oh, hey, you're looking at me. Don't look at me. Hey, you're machine gunning soul arrow stuff at me. Don't do that. I take offense to that and kill you for it. Do it, and then no curse it. Whoa, what? Dunk head in wax. Eh, what's the worst that could happen? Now, what's up here? I don't know why my head's dunked in wax. Did it change anything? Magic resist is unchanged. Everything else is unchanged. I thought for a second, but that absorption's actually from the ring I'm wearing. Covered in wax. Okay. But yeah, that's the ring. That's all the ring. I don't see any other changes. Resistances are all the same. Attacks are all the same. Defenses are all the same. Health is the same, more or less. Everything else appears to be the same. I just have wax all over my head. So I look somewhat silly, but really no worse for the wear. Oh, great. Okay, well, whatever. I got wax in my head. Hey, I got the thing! No need for bridges. Soul of a Crestfallen Knight. I actually have quite a few. How many solid souls do I have? I have amassed a collection of solid souls. Somewhere in the 50, 60,000 soul range in total. Getting a bit stingy about them. I mean, I'm at level 107, and I only plan to level up to 120, so I don't really need a huge amount of souls at this point. Let's dunk everything in wax. No, but the wax doesn't hold. All right, whatever. I look really silly like this. Oh, well, whatever. It's over here. Any thralls? Any thralls with flame with red hot axes? Any other sorcerers? Wait a sec, who are you? You're someone who also has a head covered in axe. In wax. Not an axe. That's arguably worse. At least it's worse for everyone around you. Alright, I'll get that in the next time I'm through here. Titanite lizards. Never really sure about chasing them the first time around. What does the message say? Illusory wall ahead. You lie. Well, I mean, lie is a bit too strong of a word. But, oh, neat. That's a different kind of trap. I haven't seen that one before. Kind of ties into the idea of magic books, though, pretty well. Eh, it looks relatively safe after the first shot off, but I'm not going to risk it. Lever ahead. Does it move one of these staircases? Oh, the wax went away. Oh, it's not an illusory wall. It's a wall that a lever gets rid of. Interesting. All right, well, the first thing I want to do is see what's up the staircase. Ow! Okay. Then I want to see what's over here. I think this is a valid chest. Yes, it is. It's rarely a bad idea to double check. Witch's locks. It is a flame whip. Or it's a whip. A whip fashioned from the black hair of the daughter of the Witch of Izalith, creator of the Flame of Chaos. The long shining locks woven together to create this whip are imbued with the essence of fire, which can be channeled through the use of its skill, which is a flame whip that temporarily coats it in fire, which is apparently the Chaos Flame. And power within pyromancy, the only pyromancy I have gotten so far, since I still have yet to find the pyromancers. I feel kind of embarrassed about that, but yep, I might have found a couple others. Power within, forbidden pyromancy among those who internalize flame, temporarily boost attack, gradually lose HP. A pyromancer fears the flame, however, this fear subsides once it is accepted as a substitute for strength. Fair enough. I mean, I use the deep, you use fire. Seems sense. Is this oil? No. They're not curse jars either. Boy, was that ever annoying. Dark Souls 2 had a curse jar thing, although Dark Souls 2 curse was much weaker. It was just, you lose your max health without dying. Which was a marked improvement, honestly. Or at least it made it a lot easier to deal with than the curse of 1 and 3. More Waxhead! Although, I'm gonna be ending off pretty soon. Probably with a head full of wax. What am I for embers? Let's ember up. I keep forgetting to do this. And it's generally a good idea, because then you have stuff to do. Be wary of enemy. But they're a fellow Waxhead. Oh. Hey! The wax goes on fire? Is that a special thing? Are we friends? Nope! Apparently Waxhead... No honor among Waxheadeds. Or among the Waxheaded. That's the takeaway from today. Oh yeah, right, that enemy. Titanite scale, nice. I mean, as I mentioned before, I've got more than enough Titanite scales for what I want. And I'm going to assume that's Avalyn. Avalyn is a special crossbow. It fires 3 bolts in quick succession. And you originally got it, at least as far as Dark Souls is concerned, in the Duke's archives, dropping down onto a bookshelf from... Oh, for crying out loud, would you guys stop it? There we go, thank you. Yeah, you got it from dropping onto a book owl shelf. Nope, Titanite scales, never mind. Bit of a precarious drop onto a bookshelf, but yeah, that was a thing. Super, super powerful, well, interesting crossbow. I'm not sure how powerful it's necessarily, but it is interesting. And shortcut down to, ow, that was rude. Understandable, but, you know, rude. Where does the shortcut lead to exactly? Oh, that's where... Okay, so that's the area where the sorcerer thing that's trying to kill me, that's where it started. That's where the shortcut's to. And also, if I can find some cover... That looks like an area I can drop down to later on. Alright, so... Oh, we didn't set my wax on fire. Also, you're a fool. Just throwing that out there, little thrall. You're a fool. Alright, and the other one... You're dead. Are these close enough to... Well, yep. I can dunk more head in wax. What does that do? Like, I can't figure out what that does, but... I mean, it's evidently a thing. But I don't notice any changes. Well, I think this is probably as good a place as any to end the episode. That's the area I've got to drop down to, I think, in order to get over there, in order to get over to wherever that item is. That's right there. Don't know what it is, but whatever it is, probably involves dropping somewhere around here. Or maybe involves dropping... Ow! rude. Further up. More involves this lever. What does this lever do? Ow, would you stop that? Which is clearly dealing very little damage, but, you know, it's annoying. Well, I pulled a lever. No discernible effect. Right. Well. Hey, it's a ladder! Except this time I noticed it. Can I gesture on ladders? No, I can't. Okay, fine. We'll end the episode killing this thing off. Goodbye, Crystal Sage. Good riddance. Alright, well, that was a good way to end it off, I think. Ow. Dude, you're ruining my ending. I mean, the flop was adorable, but you're ruining my ending. Okay, get rid of this. Ah! There's no last enemy! Forget it! There's an endless barrage of enemies! Okay, let's just end the episode here. So, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed that. We found a ladder. A useful ladder. I can see ladders, apparently, with my head covered in wax.